Now as he was going out on the road, one came running and knelt before him.
Good teacher, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life?
Why do you call me good? No one is good but one. That is God. You know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not murder. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Do not defraud. Honor your father and your mother.
Teacher, all these things I have kept from my youth.
Then Jesus, looking at him, loved him.
One thing you lack. Go your way, sell whatever you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And come, take up the cross and follow me.
But he was sad at this word and went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions.
Now I believe that Jesus told this man to sell all he had because he knew that if this man came and followed him, as soon as things got tough, as soon as he found out what it really means to follow God, he would have turned around and went back to his nice house, back to where he had a roof over his head, back to where he had a bed to sleep in every night, back to where he was comfortable. But if he sold all that he had, there would be no reason to turn back. There would be nowhere else for him to go. So let's put ourselves in the position of the rich man. What is God telling us to get rid of and come follow him? What are the things that keep us from following God like we should? And are we willing to completely give those things up so we can have a close walk with God? So we can have a stronger relationship with Jesus?